Very good evening. I'm Lisa Broom with the CBC Evening News. Operation Tradewinds 2017 has begun, and Prime Minister Fendall Stewart says while the Caribbean has enjoyed a relatively stable security environment since the exercise began 33 years ago, recent acts of violence in Manchester and London are grisly reminders of the volatility of our times. Sharika Griffith has more.
Security forces from over 19 countries converged at St. Anne's Fort for the opening ceremony of Exercise Tradewinds 2017. Before declaring the exercise open, Prime Minister Fendall Stewart said the most recent threats to regional security have been severe weather systems. He, however, believes that the region must remain ready to react to any threat to its citizens or visitors.
This year, Exercise Tradewinds is being conducted against the backdrop of a tense and uncertain global security environment, with many more flashpoints in existence now than was the case when the last Exercise Tradewinds was held in Barbados in 2012. The tensions to which I advert are caused mainly by the activity and designs of criminal organizations which, in pursuit of their revolting agenda, prosecute nefarious acts against vulnerable and innocent law-abiding citizens.
Chief of Staff of the Barbados Defense Force, Lieutenant Colonel Glenn Granham, says the training this year will include all kinds of natural disasters and not just hurricanes.
While over the years we have tended to focus on hurricanes and their associated destruction, based on the experiences of our neighbor Haiti and the increased seismic activity across the Caribbean basin and indeed the hemisphere, we need to encompass all spheres of natural and man-made disasters.
U.S. Ambassador to Barbados Linda Tagliatella says America has shown its commitment to regional security by providing several state-of-the-art patrol boats.
To date, the American people have dedicated $263 million towards our Caribbean Basin Security Initiative partnership. As part of the Caribbean Basin Security Initiative, state-of-the-art patrol boats were procured for many of our Caribbean nations. Most of these vessels and their crews have participated in Tradewinds each year since 2014, and this year is no exception.
Exercise Tradewinds will conclude on June 17th in Trinidad and Tobago. Sharika Griffith, CBC News.
Sharika, thanks. At least one government minister is airing his opposition to the legalization of marijuana in Barbados and the Caribbean, saying sound education has a major role to play in steering society against it. Kareem Smith tells us more.
The debate on whether marijuana should be legalized in Barbados seems to be heating up once again. And Education Minister Ronald Jones is making it clear how he feels about the subject. During a regional technical workshop for education planning, he condemned efforts to have the drug legalized in Barbados. The minister's comments came just days after criminal lawyer Andrew Pilgrim called for a review of the local regulations and an easing of the approach to dealing with the illegal drug. However, Mr. Jones says there's a need for quality educators within our system to guide society in a more positive direction.
Once I ingest anything, it changes how I think. Regardless, if we use narcotic substances, I don't care what you want to call it, weed, ganja, herb, the root of God, anything you put in your body changes that body, changes that mind, and impacts in a dynamic way on how you behave.
In addition, Mr. Jones contends that much of the pressure to legalize marijuana comes from outside of the region, and that younger generations may be a bit more willing to accept it. However, even if the region is able to profit from cultivating it, he says governments must not allow the drug to penetrate societies.
Maybe if we were exporting all of it to those countries who have denied us a certain life and livelihood for a long time, we'd be better off, because the money would be coming in and we can take care of our citizens. You eat it, you use it, you drink it, you put it into cakes and medicine, send us the money, we'll do good things with it.
Meanwhile, across the region, countries continue to engage in robust discussions about the possibility of legalizing marijuana. The CARICOM Cannabis Commission is also examining this initiative. This as Jamaica continues to explore its cultivation of marijuana for medical and tourism purposes, while tolerance for the drug continues to increase worldwide. Kareem Smith, CBC News.
Thanks, Kareem. Well, too many teachers are continuing to spend time arguing for basic things rather than spending time in the classroom teaching. This assessment from Education Minister Ronald Jones, and he's again condemning arguments by some teachers for better wages and good conditions of service. His comments came during a regional technical workshop for sustainable development in education at the Accra Beach Hotel. Now, Mr. Jones says the continuous development of quality teachers continues to play an important role in the country's development, and he's urging local educators not to be distracted from that mission.
How do we correct that? Or can we correct that? Let us march rather than teach. And then to find the march didn't go anywhere and didn't do anything. So it's best to have spent the time teaching and change the parameters of our young people, change their focus and their direction to make a difference in this, to the society from which they come. Because at the end of the day, quality education, quality learning, changes the dynamics of every society, even if that society is impoverished.
Attorney General and Minister of Home Affairs Adriel Brathwaite believes the violence being played out in Barbadian schools does not have to reach that stage. He says many of the disputes develop out of trivial issues. Mr. Brathwaite is suggesting that training for teachers and guidance counselors will help.
So that they themselves are able to identify conflict from early and try to sit down with the young people and resolve it. And the last instance that I saw a quote in the newspaper that suggested that the headmaster thought that he had resolved the conflict. He thought it was settled. And of course it escalated into what we saw on our streets and stuff. So maybe indeed that's a sign that we need to do some additional training so that our teachers, our headmasters, our guidance counselors, et cetera, can not only recognize conflict from early, but indeed try to settle them in a way that is, you know, is amicable as possible.
Mr. Brathwaite's comments came at the third quarterly meeting of the Optimist International Caribbean District at the Warrens Conference Center. The focus of the meeting was conflict resolution. Mr. Brathwaite believes the youth learned some of their behavior at home. Labor Minister Senator Dr. Esther Bayosuku says Barbados can reap significant benefits from technical and vocational training. The Labor Minister was addressing a graduation ceremony for the class of 2017 of the Competency-Based Training Fund Skills for the Future program. She says one of those areas is becoming more competitive.
A strong workforce with high value and specialized skills and competencies will improve the innovation and the productivity of industries in Barbados. Already we have seen the impact of TVET and competency-based education and training in countries such as South Korea, Germany, and Singapore. The focus on TVET and competencies has resulted in South Korea and Germany recording low unemployment rates of 3.7% and 3.9% respectively last year. Now those are the kinds of figures that we are aiming to achieve here. We've seen our unemployment drop from around 12% to 9%, but I really wouldn't mind a 3.7 and lower.
Well, she also praised the employers who allowed their staff to become qualified under that program.
I am pleased that the employers represented here have recognized this and have invested in your employees as one of your most valuable and strategic resources. In today's globally competitive environment, technical and vocational education and training continues to gain significant recognition in both developed and developing countries.
We'll take a break here, but when we come back, there's more news.
Don't let your data experience slow you down. Step up to Digicel, Barbados' fastest 4G network. More than twice as fast as the slow network. Get more with Digicel. Digicel, the fastest 4G network in Barbados. Dial *153 number sign to sign up to Digicel today.
Hello friends, this is Jeff Shepherd inviting you to join us every Thursday from 6 to 7 on QFM for Nicholas Bacon Inc. Manor, always fresh.
So, in an effort to test the credibility of this so-called speed squad, we have some random questions for you to answer. How quickly can you change clothes? The bag of groceries on the table. How fast can you guys prepare a meal? And go. All right. Which network gives you the speed you prefer and enjoy?
Join the fastest team and shift your Flow fiber broadband into high gear by upgrading now at no extra cost for 3 months. Plus, enjoy the best of Flow TV for free.
Last question. Who's the fastest?
I had to ask.
Upgrade now.
Modern-day visitors to Barbados remain keen to learn about the country's rich culture and history. This from head of the Barbados Tourism Product Authority, Dr. Kerry Hall, during the National Cultural Foundation's Heritage Bus Tour. Dr. Hall believes events like the Heritage Tour appeal to travelers' tastes.
The visitor will get a phenomenal experience on the island. The Barbados brand wins. And by creating these types of events, we are looking to increase visitor spend to the island to ensure that the economy also wins. So by doing these types of events, by coming up with new products and experiences and things to do on the island that are relevant to what the traveler is looking for, that also benefit the Barbadian people, the types of events that the traveler want to spend money on because they find them to be exciting, intriguing, unique and memorable, this is how we're going to push the visitor spend and push the Barbados brand to the next level on a global scale.
The tour allowed patrons to hear some of the bittersweet stories of sugar, molasses and rum as they stopped at a number of sites across the island. Producer of the event, Alison Seeley-Smith, says she was glad to see the number of Barbadians who came out, a sign that Barbadians are interested in their own story.
We end up a week before the event and they tell me that 40 tickets have sold. There's out of 500 they tried to sell, you know. And I'm like, okay, this time they ain't coming, they ain't coming, they ain't coming this time. 4 days later, both of them sold out. So it's just that we're a last minute people. But it still stands, Bajans are interested in their own heritage and history and culture and they want to know about it.
And we're also hearing that Barbados continues to spread its tourism message. This coming weekend, a delegation from Barbados will be heading to Florida to take part in the 5th biennial Barbados Comes to Tampa event. At the session, there will be a forum which is bringing together travel agents from the southeast of the U.S. The objective is to present Barbados as a tourist destination of choice, while a business forum will also be staged. Barbados's Consul General in Miami will host a town hall meeting geared at Barbadians living in Miami. And the delegation will also be hosting an event called the Bridgetown Market, It's a Street Fair. Entertainment is also on the card, and among those taking to the stage is Griner, Red Plastic Bag, Mac Fingal, Edwin Yearwood, and the Royal Barbados Police Force Band. Established Calypsonians have been encouraged to assist their younger counterparts in developing their talents. And this from Minister of Culture Stephen Lashley. He says it would help promote less vulgarity in bashment soca lyrics. He was speaking at the launch of Phenomenal Friday 2017. Our Lorna Jones tells us more.
Stakeholders of the Phenomenal Friday event, now in its second year, are anticipating it to be bigger and better. That event comprises three contests: the semifinals of the Sweet Soca and Party Monarch competitions, and the finals of the Bashment Soca competition. Culture Minister Stephen Lashley says, with the potential of the Cropover Festival to earn over $50 million in revenue, it is important to encourage the development of the music associated with it. In reference to the controversy surrounding the lyrics of some of the Bashment Soca songs, he says we shouldn't seek to stunt the musical growth of the younger artists, but guide them in the right direction.
We have the potential to place on the world market some excellent bashment music. And as we are poised to find every niche to grow foreign exchange, I believe that this genre of music has the potential to generate foreign exchange that can be done to the benefit of Barbados.
The Caribbean Broadcasting Corporation is a major sponsor of Phenomenal Friday, and marketing officer Alicia Hinson says CBC fully supports the event.
Art is often about interpretation, so there will be differing views. As partners of the festival, we encouraged artists to put their best talents to work, delivering quality and creative lyrics as they seek to achieve the title of Bashment Soca 2016 or gain a space in the Soca, Sweet Soca, and Party Monarch competition.
Title sponsor Yellow Media Group's Chief Executive Officer Colin Francis sees the explosion in popularity of Bashment Soca as proof the Soca genre is alive and well. He says their sponsorship is an investment in the youth and gives them an avenue to display their skills.
Here we are again, partnering and taking advantage of this partnering opportunity and providing the lens of positivity within which one should closely scrutinize the nature of this competition and reasonably draw the conclusion that the very basis of its existence emanated from positive musical vibes.
Meanwhile, the first ever Bashment Soca King, Stiffy, says although he believes there will be even more Bashment Soca on the airwaves this season, he will not be letting go of his crown easily.
It's not going to be easy to take my crown in 2017 because this is all I know. Plug it on.
Phenomenal Friday will be held on July 7th at Kensington Oval, with the winner taking home $50,000. Lorna Jones, CBC News.
A potential future engineer and Team Boscobel Primary won over patrons at BMX 2017. Boscobel Primary, a first-time exhibitor, was among the several institutions taking part in the school exhibits of the show with their invention, a handheld vacuum cleaner. Head boy Kyle Jordan was among the team of 11, along with two teachers and a general worker, that brought the idea to reality. Two vacuum cleaners were made, one out of a PET bottle using battery power and the other from a water bottle using electricity. Jordan admits he had some reservations at first, but was pleased with the end product. He explained that the smaller vacuum was the more powerful of the two.
This one is more powerful because of people say it could vacuum and blow, but that one can only vacuum. For that one to vacuum, you have to bend the hose, or else it's not going to vacuum.
So tell me, after people came through and viewed that exhibit, what were they saying to you?
Whoa, how did you make that?
Another first-time exhibitor was St. Lucie Primary. Their exhibit had as its theme endless possibilities. Teacher Charmaine Jordan says the school sought to push the concept of recycling in a unique way.
Not bottles, newspaper. And we thought about all the pencil shavings children use every day, just drop them around the classroom, put them in the garbage. So we thought about using our exhibit, art, to talk about all the possibilities of the use of pencil shavings in the classroom.
Over 4,000 Barbadians have benefited from training under the Competency-Based Training Fund Skills for the Future program. Deputy Chief Education Officer Joy Adamson made the disclosure at a recent graduation for 700 students from a wide cross-section of disciplines. That program is a collaborative effort between the Ministry of Education and the Inter-American Development Bank.
To date, 4,100 persons have been trained at a cost of $16.1 million Barbados dollars. On behalf of my ministry, I want to congratulate Mr. Lowe and his officers at the Competency-Based Management Unit for managing the fund and overseeing the disbursements.
Barbados country representative of the Inter-American Development Bank, Juan Carlos de la Vinas, says the program surpassed all expectations.
To date, the CBTF
has received 138 submissions in 4 different calls for proposals. 30 proposals have been funded, representing 16 economic sectors, and 25 new programs have been defined with the input, very valuable input, from the private sector. As was mentioned before, the approved proposals aim to train a total of 4,160 persons. And to date, 61% have been trained and 30% have been certified.
Members of the Pentecostal Church and the wider church body have been encouraged to continue engaging in God's good work. The call has come from Labour Minister Senator Dr. Esther Bayer-Suku at the time she was addressing the Festival of Pentecost at the Abundant Life Assembly in Bank Hall, St. Michael.
It has not just been 100 years marking time. It has been 100 years of good works. And as we look across this land, we can see where the Holy Spirit has empowered the church to be able to do things and to change lives and to change structures and institutions all across Barbados. But if you think that you've reached 100 and the Governor General will greet you and you can just sit back and relax, I have news for you. This is where all of our churches, all of us, this is where the work now begins. And that's why, on behalf of the government, I really want to encourage you in every good work.
And the minister says there's still a lot of work for the church to do.
The church has long been considered a partner of government. Certainly, it has given advice to government, successive governments, over the 50 years of our independence, and even before that. Solicited advice, and yes, unsolicited advice, and I know especially our evangelicals, they have no qualms about giving unsolicited advice, and keep it up, because your advice has certainly done the government well. The church has kept the government of Barbados on its toes. You have been the ones who have been there like that sounding board. You're the ones that say, hey, no, double check, think again, are you really sure you want to go there? And that's a very, very important role for the church to play in this country.
And still to come, we'll give you a look at what's happening with our regional neighbors. Stay with us.
Yes is a beautiful word. It empowers us. It brings satisfaction. And since you earn up to 3% cash back on everyday purchases with the Scotiabank Gold MasterCard, that's a lot of satisfaction, a lot more often. Plus, you get a welcome bonus from the get-go. Scotiabank Gold MasterCard is the card that keeps on giving, so it's easier for you to create many more precious yes moments. Apply today.
Have you or someone you know been diagnosed with diabetes? If so, it is important that you know about Glucerna. Glucerna is a nutritional supplement for people with diabetes and contains Carb Steady, which helps minimize blood sugar spikes. Manage your diabetes with Glucerna. Glucerna, nutrition for people with diabetes, designed for you.
Stick down your fork, stitch good, and get ready to laugh. It's the Mass on the Spirit's Hour every Thursday from 98.1 to 1.
5 p.m. until 6 p.m.
Nuff jokes at Egret Talk with your Royal Highness Queen Archibald Cox at Egret PC Rooms. So don't be a moon donkey or nothing Aryan. Tune in every Thursday from 98.1 to 1 from 5 o'clock to 6 o'clock for the Mass on the Spirit's 2 half-an-hours put together.
The Mark on the Space Show.
Every Thursday from 98.1 to 1.
5 p.m. until 6 p.m.
PC Rooms are down in the lunch door. If you just stop your mother belly one more day, you will be a full-blown idiot.
A review of the regional response mechanism is in the works. That's the word from Executive Director of the Caribbean Disaster Emergency Management Agency, Ronald Jackson.
We've initiated the call for proposals for a consultant to objectively look at this particular architecture that was designed back in 1991 when we were Sedera. We are now Sedema. And one of the things we want to look at is whether or not the assumptions around the design of this particular architecture still holds. It has served the region very well, but there are a number of changes that we have to look at. So we have to challenge the past assumptions upon which the system was designed. We are going to be exploring the global and regional operating environment and geopolitical environment, which will impact on the ability of the regional response mechanism.
Mr. Jackson believes there is need for a comprehensive approach to reducing risks in the Caribbean,
including addressing sound risk financing strategies. Beyond insurance, that we have to look at other ways of financing risk reduction and risk reduction strategies within the Caribbean. So we turn our attention to the 2017 hurricane season and what is being proposed.
Meantime, UNICEF has come on board, bolstering emergency supplies at one of SEDIMA's sub-regional locations. A memorandum of understanding on pre-positioned emergency supplies was signed in this regard. It was initialed by UNICEF's representative to Barbados, Kin Sandy Lewin, and executive director of SEDIMA, Ronald Jackson. Ms. Sandy Lewin says the supplies will cover the northern end of the Eastern Caribbean.
For many years, we've always had pre-positioned emergency supplies in our office here in Barbados, realizing that if something were to hit northern islands, we would not be able to get the supplies up there quickly. So based on that, the partnership we have with SEDIMA is to pre-position supplies in Antigua and Barbuda, and that's really a true synergy of our relative strengths.
In Trinidad, opposition leader Kamla Passad Bisesar is calling for a probe to be launched in what she has dubbed Armygate. This after she claims there are attempts to protect the Attorney General. Jesse Ramdeo tells us more.
Opposition leader Kamla Passad Bisesar is alleging that there appears to be an attempt to cover up and protect Attorney General Faris Al-Rari in what she has now dubbed Armygate. During an address to supporters on Monday evening, Mrs. Passad Bisesar called for a criminal investigation to determine if there was any wrongdoing by those comprising the Board of Inquiry set up to determine how the Attorney General's children came in possession of high-powered weapons after she claimed the findings were questionable.
I call upon the Commissioner of Police to forthwith commence an immediate criminal investigation into those persons all responsible for the conduct of this Board of Inquiry. It is clear they are persons who committed criminal acts to protect the AG and this government, and so they must account for their actions.
Mrs. Passad Bisesar slammed the government, accusing its leader, Dr. Keith Rowley, of putting the country's defense force in a state of disrepute. She said that the report given by former Chief of Defense Staff Kenrick Maharaj and the statement put out by the Defense Force were in conflict of each other. The Defense Force's report indicated that it was the former CDS who acted on his own volition and authorized the AG's children to use the shooting range at Kamuto. Maharaj has since denied the claims.
When we find out those who are responsible for this cover, we will close the army gate on those who are responsible. So if this is a matter in the public domain, we want a full disclosure of the facts. We want to know who is responsible for any cover-up, because right now we have conflicting reports about what transpired.
The opposition leader called for the report from the Board of Inquiry to be made public.
I call upon the Minister of National Security to immediately release the Board of Inquiry report into this matter so that the nation can see whether there was a cover-up and the extent of that cover-up.
Here's a tip now from Cooperators General Insurance.